Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. In this video we are going to see how we can use Arduino as a timer to control a relay with potentiometer to turn on and off an AC bulb or AC load or DC load. When I rotate this at the maximum, it maximum shows 30 seconds. We are setting it for 20 seconds. Here it shows, and let's start. The load is running. At any moment you can cancel. Let's set it for 3 seconds on, and it will turn off after 3 seconds. You can get the code for this project by clicking on the link which is below the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Let's get started with this. In this video we're going to use Arduino as a timer to control a relay and consequently to control a DC or AC load. And in order to set the time, you needed either a computer or you needed a screen to set the time. But in order to make it simple, I'm just using this potentiometer. And you can use any potentiometer, 1 kilo ohm, 1 kilo ohm, and up to 100 kilo ohm would be fine. And also, if you don't want to use this big potentiometer, you can use this tiny 3-pin potentiometer. That is also fine. I've put a knob here, and then the minimum and maximum is known for me. It's very clear. What I've written is in the code that you set your minimum and maximum, and this minimum will be represented the minimum value of the voltage that is read on analog zero of this Arduino will set you at minimum time, and when you set this to the maximum, that goes to the maximum of the value that is read here. So if you set it at 10 seconds, this maximum will be 10 seconds, and if your minimum is 5 seconds, the minimum of this will be 5 seconds. So you can set it virtually any value, let's say up to 100 hours or more or less if you want. In Arduino, once you upload the code, disconnect it from computer and then supply your power, and this will independently work with this potentiometer, and you can set the value that you set through your computer. And then we have these two buttons. I will be using one for set, so when you start this device, the relay will be by default off. It will not engage, it will wait. So you press this and the relay will start working. And there is a cancel button or reset button. At any time you just press it and it will just reset the time and relay will disengage. You can use available relay modules with simple 3-pin and all the other circuits, or you can have your own relay and just wire it and connect it. It works the same, except you have some extra wire here. Or maybe if you're using Omron or other type of relay. For this one, I have a separate video explaining how to use this relay. The link will be provided below the description. This is the relay that you might use, or any other relay you have. But if you're using the relay module, relay has these 3 pins for your load. You can connect your one wire here and the other one wire here, and the relay engages, it will connect it. These 2 pins are normally closed, so you will not use it for this purpose. 3 wires here on the relay. On this side, the first one is VCC, will be connected to 5 volts of Arduino. This is ground, connected to the ground of Arduino. And this is N, this will be connected to pin 8 of Arduino, which I'm going to show you next. This red light, red LED, is turned on when you connect the power or VCC and ground. And this green will turn on when the signal comes here. As we mentioned, this is low trigger. When it receives 0 volts, the relay will be on. When it receives 5 volts, the relay will go off. When you're using a relay, pay attention to the current rating of a relay. For example, this is a very tiny relay, and the current rating is 2 ampere for 30 volts, 0.5 ampere for 100 volts, and 0.6 ampere for 125 volts. This is the amount of current that it can handle. When you're using a relay, pay attention to the current rating of a relay. For example, this is a very tiny relay, and the current rating is 2 ampere for 30 volts, 0.5 ampere for 100 volts, and 0.6 ampere 425 volts. This is the amount of current that it can handle. And this can handle 10 ampere at 28 volts and 10 ampere at all voltages, 120 and 250 and 30 volts. So to understand how much this can handle, in North America, the voltage is 120 volts times 10 ampere is 1,200 watt, or 1.2 kilowatt. If you're in Asia and Europe, the voltage is, let's say, 220 or 240 volts. For 220 times 10 is 2,200 watt, or 2.2 kilowatt, this relay can handle. And the same way, this one, you have to also multiply the voltage times the current to get the power. And the same way, this is a 12 volt relay, but the rating is 10 ampere for majority of the voltages. To avoid fire and overheating, do not allow the current above the rated current to pass through this relay. Let me explain the wiring. This is an AC desktop bulb, and this is a power plug that I connected to the wall, and 120 volts, which will turn on and off. Now, at this point, I've cut one of these two wires at this point and twisted it and soldered it, can be connected to relay. Job of relay is to connect this, and the AC bulb is on, or AC load, whatever fan you have, and disconnect it to turn it off. So I will be connecting these two to the relay. And the two wires that I showed you for the relay, they're connected here on this side. Change this wire on this side, and every time the relay is on, the load will be off. And every time the relay is off, the load will be on. But this is just normal operation. When the relay is on, the light is on, or the load is on. On the relay, we have three wires, VCC connected to 5 volts here. The middle one is ground, connected to the ground. And the last pin is in. This is connected to pin 8. For the push button, this is ground. I've one ground here, which I also move connected to this wire. This push button is connected. This is a two-pin push button. One will be connected here, which goes to the ground, and the other one from here goes to pin 4, which is in here. The second push button, same way on this side, it is connected to the ground, to this blue, which is connected to the ground. And on this side, this pin is connected to this blue, which is connected to pin 2. Push buttons are connected to pin 2 and pin 3. Now, potentiometer, the two sides, one is connected to 5 volts, the other one is connected to the ground. These two pins, if you switch them, it will change the direction of setting minimum and maximum. For example, maximum is on this side, and minimum is on this side. If you switch these two wires, the minimum and maximum will be changed. The middle pin, which is the actual value, is connected to analog 0. Let me now explain the code. I've set pin 8 for the relay. I call it relay pin, and pot pin or potentiometer pin is analog 0, and we have a reset pin, pin 3, and a start pin, pin 2. These are two pins. That is, one is used for start when you push it, the time starts, the other one resets and cancels. And then the relay type, because we have two types of relay module, high trigger and low trigger, you inside the single quotation you put L or H. And this is the maximum. You can set the maximum time. For example, this is set now for 30 seconds or 30,000 milliseconds. Put it at milliseconds. And this is for 3 seconds or 3,000 milliseconds. Do not change this. The duration is a variable that's holding the duration that you set with the potentiometer. Pot value is setting, memorizing the potentiometer between 0 and 1024 values. Remember, time is the time that is set as the time that you press the button. Relay state is holding the state of relay if it's on or off. Remember that reset pin must be pin 2 or 3, because I'm using interrupt in Arduino Uno, other pins will not work. For Arduino Wi-Fi, all pins are okay. For the Arduino Mega, these are the pins. I will provide you the link. So these are the interrupt or reset pin that I use. Inside the setup, I've set relay pin as an output, and I set reset pin as input pull-up and start pin input pull-up. I use a pull-up to eliminate use of extra resistor. I have a video explaining that. I will also provide the link for you if you want to watch it. I will not spend time on that. And then this is an important line, attached interrupt, and this digital pin to interrupt reset pin, the one that I mentioned, and this is a function name, and it will check it when the switch is pressed and the low is detected. So interrupt will happen. This will interrupt the process of our relay timing. And then we initialize the 9600 baud, the serial monitor. This is a value mass match, otherwise you'll not be able to read this text. And then because we are setting two types of high trigger and low trigger, I set this here, checking it to turn off the relay at the beginning. So if it's low trigger, we are setting the digital pin high. This will turn off the relay, and also it prints this text for us. If low is low trigger is not there, if it's high trigger, we just set relay pin to low to turn it off. Then inside the loop, we read using analog read, pot pin, potentiometer pin. We read the value and we divide it by 10. Dividing by 10 will reduce the sensitivity of potentiometer, because constantly the value is changing and fluctuating, so we just disregard the 10 value or first digit on the right side, and the value will be stored here. And then we using the map, we get this value, and we say the value is between 0 and 1023, and because we have divided it by 10, I discard the last digit, so I make it 102. It's pretty close. And then we say map this between minimum and maximum value that you set in here, between minimum and maximum. So we will get the actual duration in millisecond. And then we check here digital read, start pin. If it's low, which means if it is pressed, then we remember the current time using the millis. We store the value in this variable, which is defined above, and also we set the value of relay connected or requested, so this will be stored above. And then we run this function, which I'm going to explain next. It goes and controls the relay. And here this loop continuously checks if the duration, the current time, minus the remember time. Remember time is always smaller because this time constantly increasing as the time passes. If it's subtracting this from this, and we check it, if the difference between these two is bigger than duration, then we set the relay to zero. So this is turning the relay off, the status zero, and then running the control function. This is just printing the time duration divided by 1000 and prints it as a second for us. And then we wait 200 milliseconds to just go through the loop. Now let me explain the control relay. The control relay checks if relay type is L and status is equal 1. Then we set the relay low mean activate, and also we print this text. If the status of relay was on, then we set it off, because the type is low. Off, this means turn off. Now if it's not else, then at 1 we say high, else we set it low. This is this function. An important section of this is the interrupt that I used. And this reset means use this function. This is a function name without those opening and closing parentheses. Every time this reset pin is pressed, so this is when this runs, we set the duration to zero, the main variable that is defined at the top. And then we check if the relay type is low trigger, then we set the relay pin high, so that high trigger relay is off. If it's not, else we set it at low, the relay will be off, and also we print this text, which is when it runs, it will also print this relay off. Let me now demonstrate the AC bulb is now connected. This is my potentiometer. The two buttons are here. This right button is to start the time, the relay, and this is for reset or canceling the activation of light. Right now it shows that my time is set for 9 seconds. I can change it, that's a maximum. I can change it even for 0 second. I set it. So let's say it is set now for 4 seconds. When I press this, the light goes on for 4 seconds. Also it shows here the status. And if the light is off, also it shows the relay is off. Now let me change it to 6 seconds. Now that is 6 seconds, and I will cancel it at the middle. It's running, but I can just cancel it at any moment. Run it again and cancel it at any moment. Now I set the minimum 3 seconds, the maximum for 30 seconds. You can see here when I rotate it to the left, the maximum, the minimum is 3 seconds. When I rotate this at the maximum, it maximum shows 30 seconds. Now let's put it around. So let's see if we can set it for 20 seconds. Let me rotate it. So you're setting it for 20 seconds. Here it shows, and let's start. The load is running. At any moment, you can cancel. Let's set it for 3 seconds on, and it will turn off after 3 seconds. Thank you for watching. This was how to use Arduino with potentiometer and a relay to control an AC bulb. If you like this video, please thumb up, and also please subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.